We're here in Kimbe Bay in West New Britain province of Papua New Guinea. We're working on a project which is supporting the Coral Triangle Initiative, which is part of a multinational initiative between Papua New Guinea, the Solomon Islands, Timor-Leste, Indonesia, Malaysia and the Philippines to try and protect a globally important area of marine biodiversity while also enhancing and enabling communities to have improved livelihoods and food security. This project is part of the Australian Government's support for the Coral Triangle Initiative, and the project is aiming to develop a method which can combine local stakeholders' knowledge with scientific knowledge to plan for the future of livelihoods while also trying to protect and maintain the crucial marine biodiversity in this part of the Coral Triangle. Our project is aiming to develop a participatory research method which brings together multiple stakeholders, both at the community level but also at the government and NGO level, to think about the future. We provide information on potential climate change but also other change such as population growth, and we are encouraging communities through this method to think about the future and design adaptation strategies which could cope for any eventuality. Our workshops are showing that some of the things that people can do to cope with climate change but also other forms of change. So we invite people who are from the provincial government, from the national government, from the local level governments, but also from the villages themselves. So we aim to bring those people together so that they can exchange ideas and learn collectively about the future and their current issues and how they need to solve their current issues to deal with potential uncertainty and change in the future.
As a community development worker, I have learned so many things in this project, and especially the workshops that I've attended, in terms of how to take the communities through in understanding the changes that are taking place, whether it be with marine, terrestrial or development projects that are happening, and how the communities are involved in this process to adapt to the changes.
Yes, I think the biggest thing that I have learned is actually having a good insight into some of the issues that we are facing. Yeah. Together with CSIRO, we were able to facilitate this project in getting the West New Britain provincial government and the local level governments and various communities in West New Britain province have a good understanding of the impact of climate change and how vulnerable communities can be to rising sea levels and rising sea temperatures, but more so to really help them so that they can be able to prepare themselves so that they can be able to cope with the impact of climate change.
The project has had some impacts already. Particularly we've noticed in the workshops that people have become much more aware of the population issue. Population growth is relatively fast in West New Britain and also in other parts of Papua New Guinea, and this is having a huge effect on people's livelihoods in terms of the amount of land that's available for growing food and crops is declining rapidly. Pollution is increasing, social problems are increasing, and there's a general degradation of social conditions and particularly traditional ways of doing things. And people, I think, have been aware of the impacts, but not necessarily aware of how severe population growth is becoming and the effects that could have on their ability to adapt to change. Another impact that the project has had is enabling new innovations to be introduced to people who wouldn't otherwise know about them. So, for example, we're looking at new forms of growing garden crops which are more able to cope with climatic variation, particularly drought. Local researchers have been able to input to the workshop processes to introduce this new innovation and enable the communities to become engaged in how they can apply it. Another impact that the project has had is enabled people to think more about the role of marine resources for their livelihoods and ways that they can conserve them. And in Kimby Bay within West New Britain province, there's been a very successful program of establishing locally managed marine areas. Now, what our workshops have managed to do is illustrate to other communities outside Kimby Bay how these locally managed marine areas could be applied, but also what some of the future threats to LMMAs would be, particularly the population issue. So we've enabled communities to really think hard about how perhaps LMMAs should be reorganized and reprioritized to cope with these future impacts of change.
The study undertaken by CSIRO that's contributed a lot to what we're trying to do in terms of climate change adaptation, working in close consultation with the Office of Climate Change and our partners like the Nature Conservancy and Western Britain Provincial Administration, that has also enlightened us about the issues that needs to be dealt with, not at the national level, but at the provincial, local level, and really going down to the communities and trying to enhance the capacity of the local people to get them prepared and also to try and get them start thinking about what they should be doing rather than wait till very late.
We acknowledge that to solve the problems of the communities and to make them more adaptable for the future, it's not just science that matters. Local knowledge and local regional understanding of issues is equally important. So what we're trying to do through the project is combine our science and our perspectives of the future with local understanding of issues and problems and their perspectives of the future. And altogether that makes a much stronger approach for dealing with problems, particularly in terms of building livelihoods that are sustainable.